Hi everyone! Today I'm going to teach you how to identify an Eastern Hellbender, how to tell the difference between an Eastern Hellbender and a mudpuppy, and what you should do if you see an Eastern Hellbender.
One of the biggest problems facing Eastern Hellbender conservation is that a lot of people mistake the Hellbender for a more common species of salamander called a mudpuppy. I'll teach you a few ways to identify the two species. Let's start by talking about where they live. Eastern Hellbenders live in clean, fast-flowing rivers and streams. Mudpuppies can live in lakes, rivers, or ponds. So if you see a salamander in a lake or a pond, it could be an Eastern Hellbender, but it's more likely to be a mudpuppy. Some common names that you might know the Hellbender by are snot otter, Allegheny alligator, devil dog, or old lasagna sides. Some common names that you might know the mudpuppy by are water dog, water eel, or mud dog. This is a model replica of an average-sized adult Eastern Hellbender. He has a flat, round-shaped head, no gills, folds of skin along his sides that help him breathe underwater, and five short, round toes on his back feet.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Now let's compare the two species side by side. The Eastern Hellbender has a flat, round-shaped head. The mudpuppy's head is more shaped like a triangle. The Eastern Hellbender does not have gills. The mudpuppy has large, plume-like gills. The Eastern Hellbender has folds of skin along its sides that help it breathe underwater. The mudpuppy has very smooth skin. The Hellbender has five short, round toes on its back feet, whereas the mudpuppy only has four long, thin toes on its back feet. An adult Eastern Hellbender gets to be about 24 inches long. A mudpuppy only gets to be about 12 inches long. Eastern Hellbenders are one of North America's largest salamanders, but they start off very small, and they have gills for the first 2 years of their lives, so a lot of people mistake them for mudpuppies. But juvenile Eastern Hellbenders already have folds of skin along their sides, five toes on their back feet, and flat, round-shaped heads, just like adult Eastern Hellbenders.
Now that you can identify an Eastern Hellbender, remember, if you see one, contact your local conservation officer or go to helpthehellbender.org to report your sighting. And don't forget to take the quiz to see if you can identify an Eastern Hellbender.